Welcome everyone to another episode of Games Lost to the Ages. I'm Blitz, your host from MaddnessScene. As always, it's nice to have you with us. We're playing Super Conflict, and I'm about to do Scenario 11, Rugged Rivalry. Alright, so we got our forces bunched up over here. They have theirs. They got a flogger and a fox bat. And we have three tomcats. So they do have a tech advantage on air units, but we have more of them, which is a bigger advantage, actually. Okay. Opening moves. Yeah, that's probably just the best bet. Let's just go ahead and claim these bases here. We definitely need the SAM to counter their air units when they come in, so we don't want to do anything stupid with it right now. SAMs do have limited fuel, but my philosophy is if it shoots down one aircraft, particularly a strong one, it's served its purpose. So theoretically, maybe realistically, let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. We're trying to see if there's any way their fox bat, which moves 10 spaces, can reach my Apache helicopter. I don't think so. Man, I really hope not. You know what? I'm not going to take any chances. I'm just going to go ahead and land it. And we'll call that a turn. Probably just go for commando on this one. I usually like to go for the ITVs, but because they have a slightly better movement and attack, but given the terrain, those small advantages it has over commando are kind of negated. They're not going to be brought out to their full potential, so we'll just go ahead and see, the firepower difference isn't that much better when you're fighting in terrain. If it's in the open, though, it's a different story. Thank you. I recall, the flag tank's kind of annoying to destroy on this one, just because of the terrain. Yep, that's a goodbye. Alright. Well, like I said, there's no way I don't punish this stupidity. That's okay. Okay. That one's done. Yeah, we're actually just gonna go into a disadvantageous terrain because there's nothing that can really threaten my flag tank with right now. Yeah, 8 points of damage out of 70. Right now, they got nothing to follow up with that, so it's not a big deal. I'm gonna go after their flogger, because I want air superiority. If you destroy all of their fighter units and their ground and later on naval anti-air defense, then you pretty much have air superiority, if that's the case. Like, what this is going to allow me to do is use my helicopter at will. Okay, so that gave us enough points to produce a M60, which we will gladly go ahead and produce. See, and this is where the computer starts to act stupid. For whatever strange reason, the AI prefers to go after factories without exception. It's a fatal flaw in the design of the AI of this game, and in the later scenarios it just really costs them. Oh, he could have taken a shot at my flag tank there. Yeah, the designers of this game did a really nice job setting up difficult situations, but you can always get out of them because the computer just doesn't know how to use their advantage. City and resupply. This probably will do almost nothing to them. Yeah. We're hitting them back. I think we can get rid of the SA-13. We can actually use the helicopter to finish it off. Which is what we'll do. Yep. As long as it's weakened and you attack first with your aircraft, you're fine. Thank you. we're just 100 shy of M1A1, so let's get another commando. Wow. Must have been a big hit. I didn't think they could destroy him. I always joke with myself that when the computer puts their flag tank on a bad terrain like that, they're just surrendering. Because that's effectively what they're doing. We're gonna win it this turn. Unless stupid stuff happens. Oh yeah. That's it for that scenario. Not too bad. That gives you a little idea of how having air superiority really makes a world of a difference. Anyway, probably gonna do a few more single player ones. I'm gonna skip to the end after a certain point because a lot of the scenarios just become like they become one-sided, and they just, because the maps are so big, they take a long time to finish. So you'll see me play, like, scenario 20-something, and then I'll just skip to the very end. I'll save the big ones for when I do the two-player games. Alright, again, thanks for watching. We'll see you in another episode. Take care.